Hello friends, welcome back to my channel. My name is Chelsea. If you are new here, if you are not new, welcome back. I appreciate you for coming back. If you are new, please subscribe. I would definitely appreciate that. Feel free to watch all of my other anti-MLM commentary, true crime videos. Those will all be linked. The playlist for those will be linked up there. And then I will also have merch linked down below too. So feel free to check that out. But today I wanted to go over a little bit more of a deep dive on job listings that can be very misleading and ultimately are really just listings for MLMs. So as y'all understand, most of us, right, these days, you're just happy to have a job, period. Now, one thing that really does piss me off, and I know it makes a lot of other people mad too, is having your time wasted, especially these days, and especially when it comes to thinking that something is an actual opportunity, and then it turns out it's not. It's just someone wasting your time, just someone trying to make money off of you, and it's disgusting is what it is. So today I wanted to show you, really just go over a bunch of these job listings and show you what to look at out for, because I've talked about it a few times in my live streams and the Discord that we have for our members only Discord that we have. If you want to join that, become a channel member. That'll be next to the subscribe button. Not for iPhone users though. You have to do that on your desktop. Anyways, the Discord's really fun. I love it. However, I've had a few people reach out to me and they're like, hey, I saw this on, you know, Indeed or LinkedIn or something. My husband or boyfriend, whoever, or me was about to apply to it. And then just from the keywords that you've told us to look out for, I then realized that it was a scam. So we're gonna go over a few things. So let's go ahead and hop into it. So I have a bunch of them actually saved, but we're gonna go over a bunch of them. And then I also want to go over the main like red flags and kind of explain those to you as well. So being the professional woman that I am, I have applied for so many jobs. I have interviewed for so many jobs. I've had a lot of jobs. It's not my first rodeo looking at, you know, LinkedIn or looking on LinkedIn, or there's one called like Jobble and, you know, Indeed and Glassdoor and websites like that. Some of these jobs can, you know, be a little bit sketchy looking, but when you are younger, a lot of times you don't know. There also comes a point where it's like, okay, well, you should have done your research. But again, we can't blame the person who's being scammed, right? Okay, so let's first look at, I found a lot of them, but the one that I found the most was for Monate, of course. So we're gonna look at a few of these and then we are going to look at the red flags that you see. So this one looks as if it is posted by Monate Global. Now this is on LinkedIn. I fucking hate LinkedIn, so I deleted mine a long time ago. Fun fact, I was actually recruited through LinkedIn for one of the MLMs that I joined. I quit like 72 hours later. It's fucking crazy. Okay, so it's just at first glance, it looks kind of legit, okay? And then you scroll down and it says, direct message the job poster from Monate Global. Now that's your first red flag, is who is the job posted by? Who is the job poster? If it's not the actual company themselves, or if the person's title is not recruiter for blank or HR representative for blank, something of that sort, then that's a huge red flag. Okay, now this person, we've actually reacted to her in one of my videos, and she is a retail sales worker at Baltimore Ravens. It's just really funny that she was the one who was like crying and like sniffling. She was Sniffles McGee in one of my top fails videos, and she's a retail sales worker at Baltimore Ravens, and she's posting job postings. You have to pay to post job openings on these type of job board websites, okay? It's just what we're gonna call it from now on, just job boards, okay? So it says, I am looking for an ambitious, coachable, self-driven, and goal-oriented individuals looking for a sustainable income within the beauty and wellness industry. This is a remote position with hours to your own discretion. That's another red flag right there. If there isn't a, you know, idea of a set schedule, like it can say flexible hours, sure, but they should be able to give you a set schedule. And then also, obviously gonna keep going, we're gonna see this multiple times, but ambitious, coachable, self-driven, goal-oriented, and then sustainable income. An MLM is not a sustainable income. So this really makes me mad. And this is the first time I'm actually like reading through these. I just screenshotted or I just saved the links to a bunch of them. So y'all are about to get mad with me. All right. Training provided, no prior experience needed. Now here's the thing is that yes, with a lot of sales jobs and marketing jobs, things like that, you don't technically realistically need experience, but they will put that on the job description so that it kind of weeds out people, right? So for instance, if it says that, you know, a BA or a, you know, at least an AA is the degree is required for a position. I don't have either of those, but I have 10 years of experience. I'm still going to apply for it because then they'll be able to see that I have 10 years of experience. A lot of times that can trump the requirement for a degree, because the degree is not going to teach you how to sell anything at all. So the no experience required, however, the fact that it says no experience required, that's sketchy. So again, another red flag of you don't need any experience at all. This is going to be the best job of your life. And it's like, let's be realistic here. Okay. Product and website included. So this is already fake, because it's like, this is already completely false. The product is not included. The website is not included. You have to pay for that. So this is very sketchy already. This needs to be reported to Moni. And then this position consists of providing clients with the proper product based on their needs and concerns, which you're not qualified to do most of the time. This includes their hair type, hair texture, skin type, general wellness, etc. You will be able to assist your clients with an online ordering process and provide extraordinary customer service. Why? I've never understood why they need you to fill out the cart for them. There's no need to do that. Someone can just do it themselves. That's ordering something online. I understand if it's like, hey, can you order that for me? Like, you already have my cart on file. Okay, whatever. But like, that's also really sketchy. And I will urge all of you to go watch Savannah Marie's video that she put up today, actually. So by the time I post this, it'll probably be like 2 days ago or something like that. But it was about the Monate fraud. The person who actually she got all that information from, they messaged both of us, and they gave us basically all these details, and me and Savannah were blown away. We were like, what the actual fuck? That's crazy. So I'll be highlighting it a little bit in my next horror stories video, but please go watch Savannah's video on it. It relates to how I just said, you know, don't give them your information. Don't give them your credit card information. It's sketchy. Don't want to give away too much, but it's fucking insane. Me and Savannah were both like almost speechless, because it's not possible for me and Savannah to be speechless. So go watch Savannah's video. I will have it linked down below. I have always her channel, Deanna, Isabella, Margaret. I always have their channels linked down below. So go check out that. Oh my God, this is insane. All right. And then in addition, you will be taught how to monetize your social media platforms while building sustainable. Oh, pardon me. No, it says substantial. Okay. That's different. Okay. So I read ahead. I shouldn't have. Now I'm mad. Now it says, in addition, you will be taught how to monetize your social media platforms. No, you won't. You are not taught that in an MLM. You are not taught that. If you want to learn how to monetize your social media platforms, reach out to me, reach out to Isabella Lanter. Go follow Influencer Oasis on Instagram. She will help you. She's amazing. Like I've even learned a lot from it. She's awesome. And then also another great creator is Kelsey, the fuck's Kelsey's last name? Kelsey G, something like that. I'll have her Instagram link down below too. I personally, and Isabella says this too, one of our biggest gripes, specifically me and Isabella, since we're like in like the influencer world, we hate the fact that they are, you know, targeting people who want to become influencers. Joining an MLM does not make you an influencer, okay? At all, any way, shape, or form. No, never, no, no. They don't teach you how to monetize your social media. I monetize my social media. I get paid to post certain things. I, you know, have sponsorships. I have partnerships. Working on a partnership right now with, can't talk about it, but I'm really excited. I almost cried last night. And like, that's important. Working with different, you know, marketing firms. And I'm working with one in my area right now, and they're fucking awesome, and I love them. That's monetizing your social media. Working for an MLM and scamming people through your social media is not monetizing your social media. I have long nails right now. I have to make all the nail noises. I look like Dolly. That's her name. Her name's Dolly. Her name was Barbie, but now her name has to be Dolly. All right. Now it says, in addition, you will be taught to monetize your social medias, like I just went off about, sorry. And then while building substantial and residual income. Substantial income. The average gross income for a Monate rep in 2019, I cannot wait to see the 2020 income disclosure statement, but in 2019 was $809. How is that substantial? And it says residual income. Working in an MLM is not residual income, especially since you keep working constantly. You never stop, because the failure rate is so high, the turnover rate is so high, you're going to keep working and keep recruiting for the rest of your life. It's a lot. It's crazy. Now, a good example of residual income is like if we were to move out of this house and move into another house, then we kept this and we're renting out this house. That's residual income. It's like we already own this and we're just making a profit off of it. Like that doesn't take work, you know? So I don't know why they always talk about residual income and passive income and stuff like that when it's like, no, that applies to something that you put the work up front and then like now you're not really doing anything for it. Like my past YouTube videos, they keep getting views and I'm not doing anything with them. I put the work up front and I leave it and then I'm making money off of it continuously. With an MLM, you never stop working ever. It is is crazy. I don't know why they say that all of this is false. All this is fake. This drives me crazy. Oh my God. Okay. Our motto is building beautiful lives. There are no minimums or quotas, but there are, because you have to hit certain qualifications to make a rank, and then you have to hit certain qualifications to keep a rank. So yes, there are quotas, there are minimums to keep and make your ranks. I don't know why they say that there aren't, but there are. This next one's my favorite. You do not, in all caps, have to recruit to make an income. See, but like, why would she put that there? If, like, this is why this girl's not like doing well in an MLM, is because she's saying like, well, you don't have to recruit. Why wouldn't you want the people below you to recruit? Why wouldn't you want them to? Like, if you're in an MLM, it's crazy. And then it says reselling of any products. All products are manufactured in Miami, Florida. Okay. And then it says fully commission. That is another red flag. As a salesperson, I don't want you to ever work at a place that is fully commission. Almost all sales positions will have a very, very tiny, minuscule, the smallest ever salary, so that you at least have something in your pocket if you don't like hit commission or make commission or sell anything, right? Now that's fine, but as a salesperson, you never want to be full commission. It blows. So that's a red flag as well, okay? And then we're going to go over all of our red flags at the end of this video too, okay? Because I want to make sure I'm making it really concise on what you need to look out for. Okay, and it says job requirements. There's only three. 18 plus, coachable, must live in US, Canada, United Kingdom, Ireland, and Poland. And then seniority level, associate. Does that make sense? Employment type, other. It's 1099. Job functions, sales, business development. Industries, executive office. Ma'am, what? None of that matches up with brand ambassador, which is the title of this job. So go back later today after I'm editing this video, because I'm going to report that to LinkedIn. However, you pay money to post job listings. So I wonder how much money this girl's losing. How much are you losing, girlfriend? Better tell me. It's insane. Okay, next one is by a market. Same thing, right? It looks slightly legit. Looks like it's posted by Monate, but it's not. And this one is for social media influencer. You're not hired as a social media influencer. No one hires you. You do that yourself. You become a social media influencer yourself by the hard work you put in and the time and the content you put out. No one hiring you is going to make you a social media influencer. That's not how it works. Out of Philly, PA. And it says that she's a market mentor. So she's at the Cadillac level with Monate Global. And this one's a little bit more in depth. I'm assuming this girl's higher up in the company than the last girl. But it says, we're looking for, and she said we, not I, we. So it gives it a little bit more legitimacy. But it says, we're looking for enthusiastic social media influencers to be the face of the company and promote the products and services. So misleading. If you enjoy communicating with customers, both online and offline, we would like to meet you. So this one is not only very misleading, but it's more, I'd say, comes off as like more professional. It's like reading this one, it sounds like she's more associated with an actual company, if that makes sense, which is horrible, obviously, because it's all bullshit, as we know. Okay, then read more. And it says to be a successful candidate, you will need to be coachable and open to learning new tasks. You must be outgoing and have a passion or love for beauty and wellness. You should be an excellent social media user with the ability to advertise our products and answer client queries online. I'll show you a query. That doesn't make sense, Chelsea. Ultimately, you should be able to increase our company's brand awareness and generate new sales opportunities. So let's go ahead and look at the responsibilities. Post about our products online. Create and share product spotlights. Network and build trusting relationships with potential customers and potential partners. That's a big aspect of that. Use word of mouth marketing techniques. Like referring our company to friends. Attend and host marketing events, not mandatory with COVID-19, except for there were about 100 of them in Miami, and a bunch of them traveled from Toronto to go to it. All right, so strong social media presence on multiple platforms, experience creating online content, entry level is welcome to apply. Like, see, this one is, I mean, we all know it's bullshit, but this one's extra sketchy, or rather it seems less sketchy, but we all know it, that makes it more sketchy. Familiarity with scheduling tools for social media, like calendar, Zoom, and email. What? Excellent communication skills, professional attitude, an outgoing, friendly personality, and a desire to meet new people. Experience in sales or marketing is a major plus. Employment type, full-time. Seniority level, not applicable. Industries, executive office. Such bullshit. Like, that is such garbage. Okay. And then this one is entry level brand ambassador. And then it's from a marketing mentor. And it says, I see, not we. We makes it sound like you're with the organization. So I'm looking for a coachable, self-driven, goal-oriented individuals looking for a career in the beauty and wellness industry. See, it's just taking advantage of people who, you know, maybe are actually looking for a career and to go this route, which is really, really obnoxious. Again, products and website provided. It's not provided to you. You have to pay for it. So this one's basically just a copy of the other girls. Like an exact, yeah, this is an exact copy of the other one, of the first one we read. This is so insane. Okay, enough with Monate. They suck. All right, this is one from Arbon, independent consultant. And again, it's posted by someone that their header on LinkedIn is outgoing and a hard worker. Really, girl? Is that what you are? Okay. And her thing is super culty. It says, I'm looking to empower others. I'm looking for people who want a change or are looking for a second source of income that can fit with a busy schedule. Arbon consultants work to change lives. With our beneficial business and products, we are an online beauty and wellness company, and our mission is to help you maintain a healthy lifestyle inside and out. I'm looking for coachable and hardworking individuals who want to be their own bosses. So am I my own boss, or am I applying to be my own boss? They act like you can just apply to anything. Hi, I'd like to apply to be a millionaire. I'm looking for people who want to be a millionaire. I want to be a goose. Can I be a goose? Okay, this one is foreign exchange trader. IAM Academy. And of course, it's from someone doesn't work with the company. Like, it needs to be posted by the company or by their HR rep. That's what needs to happen. All right. And this one says, who's looking for a new opportunity? Would you like to work from your phone? I invest in the foreign exchange market. Forex. Anyone can enroll. The requirements of this one are probably my favorite thing in the world. It says you have to be serious about your money. They ain't fucking around. And then 18 years or older, you have to have at least 1 hour a day free. That's all it takes, 1 hour. You must be coachable. You must have a smartphone. Okay. Investor/millionaire mindset. Yeah, got me there. $199 enrollment fee. Promo won't last long. Oh, it won't? Like, what are you doing? Oh my God, the next part's even better. We are building generational wealth and breaking generational curses. What? You know, when your family's cursed and you have to join an MLM to break the curse? What is happening? Jesus Christ. It's 2021. There's more ways to make money other than a 9-to-5. You're right, but not in an MLM. I'm sorry, but no, not at all. Okay, and then here's a Mary Kay consultant doing the absolute bare minimum. Then in the greater Tampa Bay area, I better watch out. And it says that she's a Mary Kay consultant at Mary Kay Cosmetics. And then all it says is looking for outgoing people, training provided. Yeah, she doesn't fuck around. She gets right in there. Okay, guys, so let's go over our red flags. So first things first, if the job posting is from an MLM, you just log right off there. That's just keep on scrolling. If you don't know if it's an MLM or if it doesn't say the name, then just Google it. Is blank an MLM? Or if it doesn't say the name, message the person and ask for the fucking name of the company. That's a huge red flag, though, if it doesn't say the name of the company, okay? It needs to say the name of the company. No reputable recruiter, HR rep, anyone like that would ever, hiring manager would ever put a job posting on the internet that doesn't say the name of fucking company that they work for, okay? And then also look out for words like financial freedom. If they're promising too much, keep scrolling, get out of there. If they're talking about fucking curses and generational wealth, get out. And then changing lives. Changing lives is a huge one. I don't like that. And then yes, coachable and driven and things like that. Sure, actual job listings use those too, but not really. Like a lot of them don't at all. And another thing too, I saw on a lot of these, they didn't actually put on there the, like, what you're going to be doing, right? It was just like, do you want to make a lot of money? Here you go. Like, what are you doing? Another thing that I actually just thought of is if there's a bunch of listings posted by different people that are associated with the same company, why would that be? That says a bunch of different things, but it's technically for the same position. Like, that ain't it. There's no, for an actual company, how it works is whoever it is, the HR department, the recruiter, the someone posts it, and that's it. There's not going to be a fucking janitor doing it. There's not going to be a customer service rep isn't going to post the same one. Like, that's not how that works in an actual company. And I know it sounds rude of me, but please don't be naive. For the love of God, please don't be naive. I know a lot of people don't know better. And especially, I know people hate when I touch my wigs, but shut up. Especially during this time that we're in, where it's fucking crazy. Everyone's just happy to have a job, period. I get it. I was there. That's why I kept my job for so long when I really wanted to quit. But the thing is that we're all, you know, jumping at an opportunity, you know, just really wanting it to be true. People are scammers. You still need to have your guard up and be careful and fucking be, just question everything, please. Question everything. Okay. Now, a lot of times they will use words like marketing, advertising, influencer, brand ambassador, and things like that, right? So we saw a few of them. That's what it was. Also, when it comes to the Forex trader, that's just idiotic, period. Because people who are like brokers and actual traders, they're not going to want to recruit other people to do the same thing. That's not how that works. So that's another fucking video for another time. I've been researching Forex trading and IM Academy for so long. It is a monster in itself, and it's confusing, and it's just a lot. So please be patient with me on that one. I know I have a lot of people who really want me to go over that, but it's so much. Okay. When it doesn't say anything about a schedule, when it doesn't say anything about like the work hours, when it's like, oh, flexible schedule. Okay. I understand it's flexible, but what are the actual hours of operation? And then also work from your phone. No. I don't care what position it is that you're going out for. Sure. A lot of places you can, you know, just respond to emails or, you know, have Salesforce on your phone or, you know, do, you know, marketing and sales on your phone. But most places you need to have a fucking laptop, okay, to actually be able to work. There's nearly no legitimate job opportunity for like an actual legitimate company that's going to post on there, work from your phone, work from anywhere, work from Wi-Fi. Don't do that. Please look out for these like hot button or red flags. Please look out for these red flags. Also, no experience needed. Again, I get it. Some realistically, in some like sales jobs, you don't actually need experience. As long as you know, have the personality for it, fine. But it will still usually always say requirements. You need to have this much experience. You need to have this, you need to have that. When applying for something, if you really want to go out for it and you have the experience or a degree or the, you know, vice versa, and it says you need, you know, both or one or the other, something like that, just fucking go for it. If it's an actual opportunity, these are not actual opportunities. They're saying that all your dreams are going to come true. You can work from your phone and you don't have to have any experience at all, and that you're going to break every family curse you've ever had. Why would you believe that? Unfortunately, people do. All right, guys, I know this video was a little bit all over the place, but I wanted it to be, you know, more of a like a big sister conversation, basically me scolding you and telling you what to look out for. It's obnoxious. I hate whenever I see these. I cannot stand, especially on Facebook too, whenever anyone's like, need a job. And it's like, bitch, why are you posting it on your Facebook? That's not real. Like, you're just trying to recruit people. Or if they don't tell, if you see in the comments, like they're not actually telling people information, and they're like, I DM'd you, I PM'd you, I messaged you. And it's like, why don't you just say it? Just say it. But they won't, because it's an MLM. That's why. If things are vague, that's what it is. For instance, I'm not gonna say, hey guys, I need, you know, if I need someone to take pictures of me, or if I need, you know, to hire someone to do a service for me, I'm not gonna say, hey, need a job, and say, direct message me or comment below. They only say comment below so that they can get other people to see like, oh, other people are interested. I wanna be interested too. Then they just private message you. That's not how that works. If it's a legitimate job opportunity and you want, it's like quality work that you're actually getting paid for, what you would do, for instance, I would say, hey guys, I need, you know, this, like, this is the requirement, blah, blah, like I need someone preferably like this, and this is how much you'd make an hour, because I don't want just anyone messaging me, right? But these people don't care who you are, just that you have enough money to sign up. That's it. You're just a paycheck to them. You're just a recruitment bonus. That's it. They don't care about you. Please know that you're better than that. Please know how valuable you are. Please, for the love of God, don't be naive. Do your research, do your due diligence, and just know that you're better than that, okay? So I really hope y'all enjoyed this video. I hope you enjoyed meeting Dolly. She needs to be plucked a little bit more, but she's here. Her sister Veronica is up there. She's literally this, but the brown version. And I'll probably wear her in my next video. So I love you guys. Subscribe, like, comment, all those things. And above all else, stay spicy. Bye.